Jonesy does it somehow or other.
Yes, he
known
does.
To happen once in a while, but
he is the master.
Thankfully, there is video. We can catch up on certain things that we miss every day, right?
Yeah, except they had a little breakdown. Is that shot good?
Is that right?
Yeah, he couldn't. As we talked to him, what, Cozy, two hours before the game today, he had still not seen last night's game. He was hoping to maybe see a period of it before the game started, but got the rave reviews, got the full scouting report from Craig Berube. Here's a shot out in front. They score. I thought it was in the net. Came right back out, and they do score. Brassard firing that one in, and it came right back out very quickly. Get used to that with these new nets. And the Rangers had the first goal of this game, 1:10 into the second period.
Brassard gets it past his former goaltender with the Columbus Blue Jackets, and Steve Mason, a good quick play down low by Zuccarello, gets it out there, and there's Brassard, who's demonstrated some good offensive abilities last year for the New York Rangers. Was a real pleasant surprise after coming over in the Marion Gabrick trade.
Well, Zuccarello is going to make the good play. This is where Mason gets tripped up a little bit because he really doesn't know where the puck is, because Zuccarello put the brakes on behind the net, gets it out to Brassard very quick with the left-hand shot, and Mason actually didn't stay on the pipe. He got in the middle of the net, and that allowed Brassard to fire it to his left.
Derek Brassard, many feel he is the X factor for this Rangers team. The way he performed in the playoffs for them, and he feels as though he's had that in him, just didn't have it for him in Columbus, but certainly played well with the Rangers last year, and he's been noticeable in this game.
Had some injuries, too, in Columbus after getting off to a great start as a rookie. I think there were shoulder issues for Brassard, and Glenn Sather picked him up last year, and he certainly